this is Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and today we're here in front of the Dousman Stagecoach Inn, which is a historic building that has been moved here as a museum. This is the original Watertown Plank Road. That's how it got its name. It's made of wooden planks, and it made for much nicer traveling than rutted, muddy roads. This is an actual, not the original one from way back when, but this was one that was added on at a later time and then saved and moved here so they could be part of this museum.
And what's that little house over there?
That was the gatehouse. I think that's what she called it, where they took tolls for actually using the road because it was such a great advantage.
So it was kind of like a toll booth.
It was. Well, they had to pay for it somehow. So here you go. If you have a buggy and a horse, it's going to cost you a whopping 5 cents. A wagon and two horses, 10 cents. Horseback riding, only 3 cents. And you could have four livestock, and that has been eliminated.
Ooh.
I guess you can't do livestock anymore. This is one of the places where we actually do volunteer gardening work, pulling weeds, edging, that sort of thing. At this particular setting, they use only plants that were available at this time. So the early settlers had this kitchen garden, and in this garden you'll find things that the people used for not only eating but also health. They have herbs and they have very knowledgeable people that will tell you what each of these herbs was used for. This is very interesting, and I figured out that I had some of these plants in my yard and didn't even know what they were called or what they were for. This is the smokehouse where they would have smoked their meats so they would be preserved. And again, flowers that are appropriate for the time that this place was actually being used. This is the ice house. This would be used to store chunks of ice that had sawdust all around it to keep it frozen for longer into the season, because they didn't have pipes and running water at that point, so you had to store water as long into the season as possible. And you'd get those chunks out of lakes or rivers before they actually melted. This is the blacksmith shop where the horses came to get their shoes put on and the buggies came to get fixed. I'm sure they had a forge and a bellows and obviously the very talented blacksmith who not only could take care of them but also tools that needed fixing.
That must be the outhouse.
You know what that is, yep. Not in use anymore.
Hopefully.
And this is the William Donaldson house from 1852, and it was a log house, so they've taken away some of the siding so you can see actually how the logs were used and how they had packing in between the logs.
Well, I'm sure they didn't use cement back then.
No, they probably used mud, clay,
yeah,
and anything else that would mix in with the clay to make it more stable and give it a longer lifespan and also more insulation.
Well, all the flowers have been historically selected.
Yes.
Because they are appropriate for the time.
That's right.
So.
And they're maintained and added to by the gardeners who love taking care of them. And this is one of the official Monarch Way stations that we are thinking ourselves of becoming. And it's just a place in your yard, anybody can apply for one, that has plants in it that are friendly and attractive to monarch butterflies, because so much of the monarch butterfly habitat has been destroyed, either on purpose or by accident. And so this is a place where they can come, they can eat, they can raise their babies before the babies fly back to Mexico where they live over the winter. So it's not only beautiful, but it's there's a purpose for it, and they do have it cordoned off because the rabbits also love these sorts of things, and they're trying to keep it more for butterflies than rabbits.
Well, plus the deer.
And the deer. Well, this wouldn't stop a deer, but
no,
it might slow them down a little. The structure behind me, which is used today for when there are activities here at the park, what shows the original timbers that were used in the Ruby Farm barns. You can see how large they are and how roughly hewn they are. But to think that these have lasted all this while is amazing. This sign will tell us the history of the house and the grounds and who donated the house and the area and the fact that it was moved. And the fact that once the railroad came into being, this house was no longer used. This would have been typical of what people would have seen back in the 1800s when crossing over this area. This would be a typical prairie situation, like Little House on the Prairie. In order to get someplace, you'd have to hack yourself a trail to get in there. That's why having a plank road to drive on with your horses or just your wagon would be such an asset. You'd need a machete to get through here. And there'd be a lot of bees too. Well, this historic park is open to people to just come and browse. They have many events here where you can actually go in the buildings, and they even have a reenactment of Civil War battles here at least once a year. So it's a very informative, very interesting place to come and visit. We hope you've enjoyed this video and seeing some of the interesting places to visit here in Brookfield. If you enjoyed this, please give us a thumbs up. We'd love to hear your comments and answer your questions if possible. We try. And we'd love to have you be part of our garden family by subscribing. Thank you so much for watching. See you soon.
Want to check into the hotel?
I don't know. Is it haunted?
Let's go find out.
This house has a lot of names in front of it. Dousman Dunkel Bailing Inn. That's a lot of people responsible for this house being here.
Well, you want to knock on the front door, see if anybody's home?
Yeah. Anybody here?
Connect with us on YouTube.